world is strange. The whole universe is very strange. But see, when you look at the details and you find out that the rules are very simple of the game, the mechanical rules by which you can figure out exactly what's going to happen when the situation is simple. It's again this chess game business. If you were in just a corner where only a few pieces are involved, you can work out exactly what should happen. And you can always do that when there's only a few pieces. And so you know you understand it. And yet, in the real game, it's so many pieces you can't figure out what's going to happen. So there was a kind of hierarchy of different complexities. It's hard to believe. It's incredible. In fact, most people don't believe that the behavior of, say, me, Juan Yak Yak, and you, Noddy, and all this stuff, is the result of lots and lots of atoms all obeying these very simple rules. Come out that it evolves into such a creature that the billion years of life with its experiences has produced the thing with prongs that stick out like this and so on. There's such a lot in the world, there's so much distance between the fundamental rules and the final phenomena that it's almost unbelievable that the final variety of phenomena can come from such a steady operation of such simple rules.
But you've had to build the most complex scaffolding to find out the simple rules.
But it is not complicated. It's just a lot of it. And if you'd start at the beginning, which nobody wants to do, I mean, you come in to me now in an interview and you're asking me about the latest discoveries of the day. Nobody ever asks about a simple, ordinary phenomenon in the street. Oh, like, what about those colors? Or something like that. We have a nice interview, explain all about the colors, butterfly wings, whole big deal. Don't care about that. You want the big final result. So then it's going to be complicated because I am at the end of a 400 years, a very effective method of finding things out about the world. It has to do with curiosity. It has to do with people wondering what makes something do something. And then to discover that if you try to get answers, that they're related to each other. That things that make the wind make the waves. And the motion of water is like the motion of air, is like the motion of sand. The fact that things have common features turns out more and more universal. What we're looking for is how everything works and what makes everything work. But it's curiosity as to where we are, what we are. It's very much more exciting to discover we're on a ball, half of it sticking upside down, it's spinning around in space. It's a mysterious force which holds us on. It's going around a great big glob of gas that's burning by a fire that's completely different than the fire, any fire we can make. Well, now we can make that fire, nuclear fire. That's a much more exciting story to many people than the tales which other people used to make up, who worried about the universe, that we were living on the back of a turtle or something like that. They were wonderful stories, but the truth is so much more remarkable. And so, what's the pleasure in physics is that, to me, is that as it's revealed, the truth is so remarkable, so amazing. And I have this disease, and many other people who have studied far enough to begin to understand a little of how things work are fascinated by it. And this fascination drives them on to such an extent that they've been able to convince governments and so on to keep supporting them in this investigation that the race is making into its own environment.